also be discussing the usurpation of fire, of fire ending to Dark Souls 3. So I just want to give you a little spoiler alert that I will be discussing a possible ending to the game Dark Souls 3. I think I just have that section at the end, and I will timestamp everything below in the sections, how I organized them. So, if you don't want to be spoiled, hopefully you can just skip that section, but just a warning, I won't go too specific.
Together from the limited information that we as
Fraught with deceit and dubiously secretive. It is no wonder. about what clues we have learned. We have learned about Yuria thus far. So, first off, we know that Yuria is from Londor, a mysterious land of cursed hollows, and we don't know exactly when or where Londor exists. And because of that, we know that Yuria herself is likely a hollow, and perhaps uses a Londorian ring to disguise herself and appear as human and not hollow. In game files, where people see under her armor and mask, she does not have the decayed hollow appearance. While other hollows, characters who are hollows, they do have that hollow appearance, so that suggests that Yuria is using a ring to alter her appearance. And yeah, so that's what we know for certain now. Now let's talk about the Sable Church. I mentioned briefly that Yuria was one of three founders of the Sable Church in Londor, and I also mentioned briefly a primordial serpent and some pilgrims, so let's get into it. The Sable Church is a church of Londor that preaches salvation to hollows, and it was founded by the three sisters, Lilaine, Yuria, and Elfried, who are nicknamed the Harlots of Death. As we know from the item description of the Sneering Mask, which is a mask worn by, quote, those who kill in the name of the Sable Church of Londor, which I will touch upon shortly. The only thing we know about the physical Sable Church, other than it being in Londor, which is confusing physically enough anyways, but we learn from the Morian Blade, which is given to us by Yuria, the description, it says, it is a twisted sword resembling the towers of Londor's Sable Church. Eight branching blades and thorns induce bleeding. So from that we know that the Sable Church is a collection of eight towers. And yeah, that's about it physically. Now, the founding sister trio, it is not definitively known that if they're biological sisters or sisters under the same covenant. However, they are referred to as daughters sometimes, which does suggest biological relations. But that's just a little interesting fact. But they serve a primordial serpent, and this primordial serpent has the name Darkstalker Kaathe. K-A-A-T-H-E. Darkstalker Kaathe, who appears in the first Souls game, the first Dark Souls game. Various items tell us that Yuria and her sisters serve a primordial serpent, but it is confirmed to be Darkstalker Kaathe, because if you kill Yuria, she says, Kaathe, I have failed thee. Now let's talk about Kaathe, saying he's kind of the Yuria and Lil Summary. So you kind of see Lil Summary, but Sable Church and their mission. And I guess Lilane's role in that. Now, Yuria is the middle sister and the attempted topic of this video. And she is a sorceress. And we know that she is a very skilled fencer. She uses the weapon Dark Drift, which is, by description, a cursed sword with an unseen blade. Yuria, a mentor of the Sable Church and an accomplished swordswoman, is said to have claimed 100 lives with this weapon. So we know that Yuria is a very skilled fighter from that. Now, Elfried is the oldest sister, and she is also known as Sister Fried, who is a boss, a very tricky boss at that, in the painted world of Ariandel DLC. Now, again, there is tons of fascinating lore on Elfried, so I want to devote a whole video to her. It'll probably be my next video, so I won't say too much. But I will say that Sister Fried at some point abandoned the Sable Church of Londor, and Yuria speaks of this. If you interact with her after defeating Sister Fried as a boss.
Sable Church offers being death.
So many.